after finishing the without communication scheme, and next we will explain about the communication scheme. In communication schemes, we have different further scheme. Now the first one is called permissive underreach scheme. So in permissive underreach scheme, for example, we have the fault in zone number one, so it will take time, it will take action in time t equal to 0.
80%.
This is 80% of the line, and if fault is here, it will take action in the time t equal to 0. But if the fault is here, in after the 80% of the line, it is sensed in zone number 2. So what will happen in this case, we have the communication between these two relays at different substation. For example, this is substation number 1, this is substation number 2. So if it is sensed in the zone number 2, so this relay will send a carrier signal, which is called carrier receive. Now for this, it will be carrier receive. From here it will send a carrier signal to this relay, to substation number 1. When it is received by the communication panel, here we have AND gate. In AND gate we have two condition: one, carrier received from the communication panel, and it is in lies in the start of zone 2, yani the fault occurs in the zone number 2. So when these two are high, it will make trip in time equal to 0 seconds, right? Not time equal to 400 milliseconds. So now we will show you this. Here the selection scheme is now disabled in this without communication. Now I will make addition, edit value, and then come to permissive under reach. Permissive under reach, okay, save. After saving, send data to device, password, after send this data to relay. Now we will create fault in these two zones, zone number 1 and zone number 2, and let's check the behavior of the relay, in which zone it is considered. For example, now this is zone 1, so when it finish the test, it will give 1 here. And generally, if without communication scheme, as we saw previously, it giving zone number 2, because it trip after 400 milliseconds. Now let's check the behavior. What is the behavior now after enabling the permissive under reach scheme? Okay, now I will start injection. Zone number 1, here 1, and here 2, but not 1. Why? We will go to binary output. As you saw this, it was showing time zone number 2. But now we have enabled the permissive underreach scheme. So here we will go to configuration and make a binary output. This binary output, this I used as a carrier signal, right? Here is the binary output number 1, normally open to close. This I will use as a carrier signal for the relay to make trip. So I make enable this, and after this I will come here and here binary output. When this is red, it means signal receive. So when it receives the signal after delay of 10 milliseconds, it will take an action. Right. Now I will inject. Here you will see this value. Showing number 1 and again showing number 1. Because this has been considered as time 0. Because we now enable the permissive underreach scheme. So this was all about the permissive underreach scheme. Now I will take different zones, fault in different zones, right, and start injection. 1 1. Now this will be considered as zone number 3 and finally zone number 4, and after this injection will get stop. So this was all about the permissive underreach scheme. Now the next scheme is a permissive overreach scheme. In permissive overreach scheme, if the fault is in zone 1 or zone 2, it will send the carrier receive signal to the another substation to make trip. Right. So simply we will enable, from the setting we will enable permissive overreach scheme. Permissive overreach, right? Okay, save and send. Enter password. Alright, and after this come to the timing and start injection. Number 1, also this is considered in number 1 because permissive overreach, and this number 3 and this one number 4, and after this the fridge will stop injection. Again, if I want another point in the time in the zone number 2, and again inject. So it will follow the sequence 1, this 2, this 3, this 4, and finally last this will be tested. So we will only see the value that it is stopped, considered as zone number 1. This will be zone number 1, this will be zone number 3, this will be zone number 4, and this will also be considered as zone number 1 because of enabling the permissive overreach scheme. We'll start injection. See, 1, here also 1, then this one 3, then this one 4, and this one also 1, and after this the injection will get stopped. So this was all about permissive overreach scheme. So we saw this already. This is the AND gate starting zone number 2 and carrier receive fault in zone 1 or zone 2. It will send the signal, and the fault is in the zone number 2. So this relay will take, will send, and this relay will receive having OR gate in this and make trip. So this was our permissive overreach scheme. Okay, now in the permissive overreach scheme we have another option called another function called weak in feed and current reversal, right? So when we will enable this weak in feed function, and how we will test, and when we will enable this current reversal method, and how we will check this, now we will tell you about this. For example, this is substation number, for example number 4, and this is the last substation on this line, substation number 5 for example, and here permissive overreach scheme is enabled, right? And what happens here, right? Fault in this area, what will happen? Source is from here, right? Because it is coming in this sequence and this is the last substation, so source is from here, so all current will come and go like this. So this, what will happen with this? This will not consider this as a fault, right? So in this case we have a certain limit for voltage, right? If it is below this voltage, then this substation, it will send signal to this to make trip. This is called weakened feed signal, or whatever the name you suggest for this, it having certain value. For example, if voltage is less than 45 or 45 voltage, then it will send the signal, because then it is considered as a fault, because here is no feeding, so it will not sense anything in this case. So for this, this is called weakened feed. Weakened feed, right? So for weakened feed scheme, now we will explain. Now we will show how to test this weakened feed, right? Okay, now how to test the weakened feed? First we will come to the sequence. We will open this stage, right? Now here I enable number of status. Number of status, I enable 2. In the first state, I will inject normal. See here, 63 volt and 0.2 ampere per phase normal injection, right? Same angle. And then go to the settings, state settings, and go to the second page. Now in second page I will inject, as I told you, our setting value is 45 volt. Here go to settings, go to the relay settings, and here we can feed voltage threshold 45 volt, right? So if it is above 45 volt, no carrier signal will be sent, no we can feed carrier signal will be sent to the last relay of the substation. And here is the time delay, or we can feed time delay 10 milliseconds. After this I will make this 44 and we will check the different value. Before this you have to make it high, this we should this should be in the mind, right, in order to show the time. Now after this settings, go and inject. First it will check in the first page and then it will check in the second page, right? So we create fault in the second state. The first state go right, right? So now this is 44 volts, so it stopped 0.03. now how we will confirm that this is the correct value? We will make change here, make it 50, make it 50 milliseconds. Okay, save. And send data to device. After this, make this value change, for example 5 or whatever the value less than the city value, I mean 45 volt. So start injection. See 0.057. so this means this is the this is our value. So that's how we will check this weekend feed. Now for example, if in the second page I make for example 46 and I inject, it will stop according to this time, 3000 milliseconds. Here you say because of no drip, this stop because of the page, because of the set value in the states settings. This is 3000 milliseconds. So the relay stop normally, the fridge gets stopped normally, not because of the drip. Now I will make this value 40 and inject. Now this come 0.067. so this was all about the weekend feed. Now the next function is the blocking scheme, enabling the blocking scheme. Now go to edit 2 selection, edit value and select blocking scheme, right? Okay, and then save. Send data to device. Okay, and then go to Freja page. Now here I will select 3 zones, zone number 1, zone number 2 and any value in zone number 4. Now if I add the blocking scheme here, what will happen? The relay will send when it is in the zone number 4. This edit send, this LED will glow, this will become high and send command to the other relay that this is out of our zone limits. So after it will take usual time to stop the Freja. And for zone number 2, it will automatically detect, it will automatically accelerate. Even though we make this output, make disable this one, carrier receive signal in this without communication. So when I make this low, it means no signal from the communication panel or from the communication scheme. So now after selecting these point, I will inject and we will see the values. Now first zone, now already this in comes zone number 1, acceleration without, and then coming in zone number 4. Now from Freja how it will go, again I will inject and we will show from the LEDs of the Freja of the MyCom relay. So I start in the injection, zone 1. Again LED for zone 1 because acceleration. And now in when detected in zone 4, send edit send, and that's how it will stop after usual time, which is for zone 4 1000 millisecond. Again if we want to see this value for zone number 4, so see this 0.18, 0.59 and 1.016, which means 1016 milliseconds. So this was all about the blocking scheme. Okay, so the next test we will do the current reversal. So for current reversal time guard,
This test is known as current reversal time guard. So for example, we have the scheme like this. Fault happened here, and this is the relay under observation. So how the relay will differentiate? This is a first fault, any forward fault, or fault in reverse. How the relay will differentiate between these faults? So usually there will be one setting to differentiate between, to give some time to the relay to differentiate that it is a reverse fault or forward fault. So how the relay will know? For example, fault here, and this is because of the reverse, so this will trip before. When this got trip, so the relay will see only now the forward fault. But this will be depend on the setting. If this open in the 10 milliseconds, then it will be considered in the forward fault, forward zone, and then the relay will take action according to the zone. I mean 0 milliseconds or 40 milliseconds, like this, right? So now we will go to the settings. This also the function of POR, permissive overreach. So first we will edit this, go to the permissive overreach, okay, save. After saving, send the settings to the relay, okay, and after this now we will select the time guard. Okay, so this is a time reversal guard, 10 milliseconds. Now this is 10 milliseconds, right? After this, we will go to the Freja page and go for okay, we will close this page. After this, go to general, proceed. Okay, now sequence. First number of status, I will create 3 status. First state normal, second state current reversal, and then forward, right? So first page 63 volt. So now this is the setting for current reversal. The first page we make all normal. First page, first state settings normal, no fault.
Right?
Voltage and nominal voltage and nominal current.
Normal voltage.
Right, now 63 volts and 0.2 ampere with the same angle, right?
Three phase,
120 degree phase shift. In the second page, we make any fault, but in reverse direction, and we make sure that this lies in the zone number 4. Here you see this phase shift of 180 degree, and here also the voltage value is low, which means fault, and this showing it is in reverse direction, right? In the third page, in the third state, now in the third state we only make a forward fault. I mean only voltage is low. Voltage is low, but the directions are in forward direction. So after applying this, we'll make start. So this is the time guard now, 0.072. Now this for 10 milliseconds. I will make this 50. Send data to device, close and inject again. Now for previous it was 0.072. let's check the value change or not. Okay, so now we make the setting 100 milliseconds for time reversal guard. After send this to relay,
save.
Send data to device. Okay, inject. Now the time guard come 0.118. previous time it was 0.072. so this is all about the time reversal guard. The relay will decide between reverse and forward current.